Hi friends, today I was working on a CNC project, and while working on it I found that the servo motor no longer wants to rotate. So I decided to repair it myself, and I am now going to post it on my channel in this video. So hopefully after watching this video you will be able to repair micro servo motors yourself instead of throwing them in the trash. This motor is sg90, which is a 9 gram micro servo motor. It is also one of the most used and least expensive servo motor. The motor body is made of semi-transparent plastic, and these two screws, these are holding the motor body together. I am now going to unscrew them. To save your time, I am increasing the video speed here. Once you have unscrewed these screws, you will also need to remove these stickers, because they are also holding the backside together. Now gently pull the body apart and try not to throw these small gears on the floor. They can easily go missing. And here you can see the problem. This wire here, it is detached from the board. You will be surprised to know that this wire detachment issue is actually very common with these type of micro servo motors. If your micro servo is not working, there is a high chance that it is also suffering from this wire detachment issue. Luckily, it is very easy to attach these wires to this board again. First, I will need to remove them, the damaged part. You don't even need a professional wire cutter, as you can use your nail cutter. I believe most of you have nail cutters at home. Gently remove the wire insulation. Be careful, as pressing too much can cut the entire wire. Once the insulation is removed, pre-solder the wire ends using your soldering iron and connect them with the circuit board. And make sure to remove any excessive solder, as it can result in a short circuit. I think the wire joints are strong enough, so I think it is now time to test this servo motor. But before I do that, if you have not already subscribed to my channel, please click on the subscribe button to see more similar technical videos. I will plug the servo connector in my servo tester, and you can see it is now moving. By the way, I am now planning to post a video on how to make your own servo tester. It is actually very easy to make one. So stay tuned for more videos and share this video with your friends. And if you have not already subscribed to my channel, please click on the subscribe button and also click on the bell icon to stay up to date with the latest videos. Take care of yourself and your family. See you soon.